just thankful for what God's doing. I didn't get to see. Give me a wave if you were at the prophetic summit. Can I see hands? Oh, a few of you. Well done. Did you enjoy it? Yeah, so wonderful to hear what the Lord's saying. If you would like to read some of the prophetic words that have come out from different prophets around the nation, thanks, Benji. You can go to, there's two ways you can do that. There's a Facebook page where we put regular updates of prophetic words as they come out from around the nation, and that is the Australian Prophetic Council. So you can just follow it, like it and follow it on Facebook, and you'll get those updates fairly regularly coming through. And then also there's the AustralianPropheticCouncil.com.au webpage where we're also putting those updates if you want to have a look. And it's worth taking it and reading it. You see, if you receive a prophet in the name of a prophet, you receive a prophet's reward. And when the prophets begin to speak, it's worth taking it, weighing it, and receiving it deliberately, saying, yes, God, I want to be aware of what you're saying, what you're doing, and I want to position myself to cooperate. You know, this is just such a big key. If we actually understand that the dinner bell's ringing, and when it's ringing, you go and get your food, you go and take it, then you actually begin to grow. You really begin to step out into the divine invitations that God's got for us. But we've got to recognize it. We've got to see these divine invitations in order to be able to respond. And unless we're hearing it, we're not able to hear what God's inviting us into. So, you know, God speaks in many different ways, but one of the ways he speaks is through the prophetic word. And I think that's a powerful thing to be able to do. So I'd encourage you to get on there, share it around, share the page, because we want as many Aussies as possible listening. I got Americans on that page writing saying, oh, we'll take that for America too. It's like, good on you. Hallelujah. But we're going to have it as well. Hallelujah. And we're going to receive it with open arms and with grateful hearts. Hallelujah. And it's been beautiful to connect with prophets from all different streams. And we are really developing magnificent friendships with senior leaders and prophets from around the nation. And because we all prophesy in part. And sometimes, you know, if a word gets released that we feel is a little bit incomplete, or perhaps it's just a word of knowledge that doesn't have a word of wisdom in it, we take it to the rest of the prophets and we encourage them to go deeper, to look further, because we believe the prophetic word should be the testimony of Jesus, like it says in the book of Revelation. The testimony of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy. And the testimony of Jesus is that as Jesus was when he walked on the earth, so he is today, hallelujah, glorified. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And Jesus always manifested himself as the answer. In that every time someone came to him for help, whether they needed food, whether they needed healing, whatever it was they came and asked him for, without fail, every single time Jesus manifested himself as the answer. Yes? It's in the book, in the scripture. Every single time, there's not one time Jesus didn't manifest himself as the answer to them when they came looking for help. He didn't heal everybody, but he healed everybody who came to him. He didn't feed everybody, but he fed everyone who came to him with need. Yes? So in the same way, we believe when a prophetic word is released, it should be the testimony of Jesus within it. So just stating what God's doing or stating what's happening without actually bringing a word of hope, bringing the word of what the answer, how Jesus wants to be the answer in that, is, I believe, an incomplete word. And we're looking for God to really mature us in the prophetic so that we have words of knowledge, words of prophecy, and words of wisdom as to how to take hold of that, what to do with that, and what God wants to do. If you hear a prophetic word that just is releasing doom and gloom and there's no answer in it, then it's not, I believe, a mature word. Because the Bible tells me that prophecy is, you know, the testimony of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy. And so if it's not testifying of the answer, then I believe it's an incomplete word. I think you need to help me a little bit more with this. Yes, hallelujah. We read the same book, Shaka Bahasa. And so we're really seeking to release mature words that can really be an encouragement and help in helping us to pray and getting those words out to the different prayer networks, throughout all the different denominations, and they're praying into it, and it's exciting. Hallelujah. Because we're not called to survive. We're called to thrive. We're not called to be on the defensive. We're called to be on the offense. I shared that the other week from Carlos Anacondia, who saw the incredible Argentine revival. And he was giving the example of a boxer in the ring, that if a boxer stops being on the offensive, he starts taking hits. And we don't want to live just trying to defend ourselves, trying to survive and trying to get by. God is waiting for us to actually lay hold of what he's got for us and begin to use the weapons of our warfare, which are mighty to the pulling down of strongholds. Hallelujah. And to be on the offensive. Because God is for you. He is so for you, and he loves you. Hallelujah. And so I want to encourage you. God is wanting to, he's wanting to speak to you. And we live in this year that we're in, 5774 is what we've come out of. In the Hebrew year, we are now entering 5775, which I thought was interesting. It came out at the council. That's like a mirror, 57 and 75. And interestingly, how God is speaking a lot through Corinthians and through 2 Peter chapter 1, that we need to be as people that are looking in the mirror of God's face and recognizing our identity. God's answering the prayers of Ephesians chapter 1 that we've been praying, Paul's prayer, that we would have the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, enlighten the eyes of our understanding so that we can know the hope of our calling, the riches of his glorious inheritance in us, the saints, and the greatness of the power toward us who believe. And that comes through looking at him. Because the Bible says, as he is, so are we in this world. So we need to get to know him. It's through the knowledge of him that we are partakers of the divine nature. And it's through knowing him, looking in the mirror of his face, letting him remind us that we've been cleansed from our sin, that we've been forgiven, hallelujah, that we're not defined by condemnation, we're not defined by our past, we're not defined by our performance, but we're defined by the performance of Christ. And the more we see him, the more we are like him, because the more we begin to believe, hooray, I have been crucified with Christ. It's no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. And he's amazing. He's lovely. Oh, he's wonderful. And everything that you see and love about him, he's now saying, everything that I have, I give to you. My nature, my righteousness, it's all yours. Hooray. Yay for Jesus. So when we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us of our sins. So we, by faith, lay hold of that forgiveness and we say, thank you, Lord. You know, I believe it's so important. 5775, if you look at 57 in the Hebrew, it's the word ayin, which means to see and by implication to obey. And we're living in the decade of the seer. This is a time where we're really beginning to see, I believe, with fresh eyes. There's a Holy Ghost awakening happening. Hallelujah. And he's giving us eyes to see. This is why I've been praying for eye salve in this season. Like Joel was prophesying before, ask for rain in the time of rain. In this decade of seeing, we should be asking for supernatural help. Give me eye salve to really see what I need to see so that I don't walk around half blind or like I'm just dreaming. I don't want to walk around. I mean, daydreaming with God is great, but God is asking us to be fully aware and fully awake. Hallelujah. So that we can recognize the divine invitations. We can begin to be intentional with our sight. We can be intentional about looking and seeing what God wants to reveal. And by implication, to obey it. You see, I believe we're in such a season of divine acceleration right now that there's an invitation to see God do exceedingly abundantly above all we can ask, hope, or imagine. Oh. But in that time of acceleration, there's also this holy reverential awe of God that I feel God bringing us into too, that there's a greater need for obedience. I remember years ago just driving on the freeway, and I was in a hurry to get to a meeting, and I was just edging over the 100 mark. And I was thinking of my mother. She used to tell me the angels jump off at over 100. And I'm like, oh, no. You know, all right. But I'm just edging over. And the Lord spoke to me so clearly. And he said, disobedience at high speed causes crashes. I went. And then I began to think about it. You know, if you're a learner driver and you're just going around the car park and you forget to indicate, you're less likely to cause a big crash than you are if you're traveling at 100 kilometers an hour and you don't indicate or you make an illegal lane change. You could not only kill yourself, you can kill a whole family. You could kill many people. Because increased pace requires increased focus and more attention to the importance of obedience. And this is a season we're entering into. It's glorious, but it's also serious. This is like you've been asking for this. And he's saying, yes, it's yes and amen. Let's go for it. Greater works than these shall they do. And he's inviting you to begin to see what you've never seen before. He's inviting us into just everything. It's so exciting what he's got for us. And I want to share some scripture with you tonight. But in that season and in that invitation is also the call to higher levels of obedience. Because if we can swiftly obey, the more quickly we learn to hear and heed his voice, the more quickly we can move with him and accomplish the glory covering the earth as the waters cover the sea. Hallelujah. As he allows the glory of God to shine through us, as he allows us to really step out and do the greater works that he's asked us to do. The Bible tells us he's laid up good works in advance for you to do. That's good. That's for you, every one of you. God has laid up good works for you to do. And when God calls them good, they're really good. But we need to have eyes to see and we need to be willing to say, yes, God, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, I'll be obedient. I just love Pastor Joel's little testimony there about, you know, having to turn back when he'd walked past. But you see, what an opportunity would have been missed if he hadn't been obedient. And God's looking for us to recognize that his ways are better than our ways. His thoughts are better than our thoughts. He's a gloriously good God. And he doesn't want to lead you into shame, pain, and disgrace. He wants to bring double recompense. Hallelujah. And he wants his glory to be revealed. Hallelujah. If you've got your Bibles, you can turn with me to Amos chapter 3. Oh, I guess so happy. I just want to squeal or do a dance. I can show my awesome. Because I tell you, this time that we're living in is so exciting. God has got exceedingly abundantly above. And that is not something we should just get familiar with. That is something we need to recognize. Okay, this is real. It's on. Hallelujah. Amos chapter 3, verse 7. Surely the Lord God does nothing unless he reveals his secret counsel to his servants, the prophets. Could I get you, Chris, could you just move that fan around, please? So I don't need it on me. He does nothing unless he reveals his secret counsel to his servants, the prophets. You know, I believe that God is looking for us to recognize that God wants to reveal secrets to us. He wants to speak to us. I mean, God's doing a lot, and he says he does nothing without revealing that to his prophets. So there's got to be some people who really need to be listening. God is looking for us, I believe, to begin to really intentionally incline our ear to him, intentionally allow him to begin to speak to us and show us things that he wants to show. God's looking for us to stand in his counsel so that we can hear what he's saying and we can proclaim what he's saying. I had an encounter a while ago, and I'd taken the kids to go and get an eye test, and they went, I sat with each one of them as they went through, had their eyes tested. And then I thought, well, I probably should get my eyes tested too. So I sat and had eye tests too. And they did the standard tests. And then the optometrist said, do you mind if I just do another test? I said, sure. And so she did another test. And she said, can I just try something else? And she did another test. I thought, I've just sat through three eye exams and you didn't do any of that then, so what's going on? And she said, it's really surprising, but you can see things other people can't see. I thought, this is interesting. It was a couple of years before I had, you know, just slightly less than 20/20, not enough to get glasses. But suddenly she said, it's so good. It's like, you know, I want to try some more things, see what you can actually do. And I went home and I was just sitting out the back and I thought, I'm going to use my eyes. See what I can see. And I began to look and I could, you know, I was looking to the furthest tree in the distance. And then the Lord just began to speak to me. He says, I want to release sight to the body like I've never seen, like they've never experienced before. I want to show them more than they've seen. And as I began to look, he said, do you want to see some more? And then in the spirit, all of a sudden, I was where I was looking. And I could see the insects. I could feel the leaves of the tree. I was in the tree. And then he said, "What do you want to see some more?" And I lifted up my eyes and suddenly I could see the same distance again. And the Lord spoke to me and he said, Catherine, I want to show my people as far as they're willing to look. And it took me by surprise. I'm, whoa, Jesus. And I began to think about that. You know, the Lord is saying that he is inviting us. He wants to show us things to come. He wants to show us detail. He wants to show us color. He wants to show us distance. But he's looking to reveal it to his friends. He's looking to reveal it to those who are willing to take time to allow the Holy Spirit to begin to show them things. Have a look at John 15:15. Are you still with me? I haven't freaked you out yet. Hallelujah. John 15:15 says, no longer do I call you slaves, for the slave does not know what his master is doing. But I've called you friends, for all things that I've heard from my Father I've made known to you. Hang on. Did you just hear what's on the table? What's available? Let me read it to you again. No longer do I call you slaves, for the slave does not know what his master is doing. But I've called you friends, for all things that I've heard from my Father, I've made known to you. These things are hidden. It's a little bit like hide and seek. The Bible says that it's the glory of God to conceal a matter, and it's the glory of kings to seek them out. The word see is in that seek. And actually in worship tonight, I had a vision of somebody playing hide and seek. It's hide and seek with God in a forest. And they didn't know, they were feeling a little bit lost, feeling a little bit frustrated. They couldn't find him. And then all of a sudden, God just jumped out and grabbed them and hugged them. And there was delight and there was joy and there was surprise. And I could feel it. I could feel the joy as he was speaking it to me. That's part of the color, I believe, that God's wanting to reveal to us as he speaks to us. He wants us to experience the emotion of his heart. But and I felt the Lord saying that there's people who've been seeking who are about to be surprised by the joy of God. They're about to be surprised at how God is going to manifest his life and his light to them. Hallelujah. And, you know, if you don't give up, if you don't change the subject, if you are persistent, it's in that persistence, it's in that unwavering perseverance, seek and you will find. But we're not to lose heart. Hallelujah. If you faint not, you know, do not grow weary of well-doing, for in the end you will reap if you faint not. God's looking for us to keep looking, to keep pressing, to keep persevering. Hallelujah. And he also hides things in the Word of God, things that we can read over and just go, oh, that's nice, and not even recognize that it's actually piping hot, glorious food that he's wanting us to have. These are divine promises. I so appreciated that prophetic word. I don't remember who gave it, but about the promises being yes and amen. Who was that again tonight? Esther. Hey, Esther, hello. I so appreciated that because this is one here. You could read that and go, oh, that's nice. But he says, it's yes and amen to you. in that I've not called you a slave anymore. I've called you a friend. For all things that I've heard from my Father, I've made known to you. He reveals his secrets to his servants, the prophets. But now he calls us friends. And he says, not only am I revealing a few secrets, everything I'm making known to you. I don't know if you got that. All things that I've heard from my Father, I've made known to you. This is not just, you know, the scripture speaks in layers. And this is a hidden treasure that God is saying, I'm willing to show you more than you've seen. I'm willing to help you. I want to be your helper beyond what you have asked for. I was sharing the other week about John 11:11. People say, why do I see 11:11 all the time? You know, I don't know. I used to think that's a bit strange. But then suddenly, all of a sudden again, God started showing me 11:11 all the time. I thought, is there something in this, God? What are you saying? And then the Lord said, John 11:11. And the scripture, John 11:11, is Jesus says to his disciples, Lazarus sleeps and I go that I might wake him up. And then when I looked up the word Lazarus, because, you know, he hides things so that we can find it, the word Lazarus means God is helper. And God is wanting to awaken us to the reality that he wants to be our helper beyond what we have understood. He wants to help us out of our slumber, and he wants to help us in every single moment of our lives. He wants to help us. You see, we have not because we ask not. And the Holy Spirit stands jealously by going, I could so help you with that. But we don't have his help because we don't ask for it. In all of your ways, acknowledge him. Become intimate with him. Become intimately acquainted with him. Become his friend. Begin to know him. Begin to ask him. Ask him to show you. Ask him to help you. We rely so much on our own understanding. Even often the things that we see, we interpret in our own understanding. And the Holy Spirit's going, oh, guys, I want to show you more, but seriously, you need to steward what I'm giving you right now. Ask me for help. I want to interpret it for you. I want to show you. I want to lead you. I want to help you. It's a divine invitation. He says, you did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you would go and bear fruit, that your fruit would remain, so that whatever you ask of the Father in my name, he may give to you. Ding-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling, there's another little dinner bell there. You know, God's heart for us is that we would recognize that he wants us to be his friends. He says, you're my friends if you obey me. And that as you recognize that he's not wanting to be your acquaintance. God's wanting to be your friend, the one that you walk with, the one that is closer than a brother, closer than a husband, a wife, a mother, a father, a daughter, a son. He wants to be intimately acquainted with you because he wants to share with you. He created you in his image so that you and he could have fellowship. And that is not fellowship that happens occasionally. That's not fellowship that happens just here and there. He is inviting you into a relationship where he wants to show you everything that's on his heart. It's a bit bigger than I think we understand. Hunger won't be satisfied with what we've had. And he spells out here what's available. God is looking for us, I believe, to allow him to just come and clear the chalkboard of our heart. I bought a little chalkboard the other day at Spotlight with the girls, and you know they've got a party coming up, and it was painted, you know, black. And the first thing I want to do is find some chalk and write on it because it's like painted blackboard. It's just begging to be written on. You ever know? Do you know that feeling? It's like, oh, just have to draw on that. I think she's so childlike. Well, I hope I stay that way. But you know, God is waiting for us to allow him to clear the chalkboard of our hearts, because he longs to show you some things that you haven't seen yet. But we tend to clutter it up. We fill it up with all sorts of entertainment, with all sorts of things. And God's saying, if you only knew, if you only knew how much I have for you, if you only knew what I want to say, if you only knew the secrets I want to share with you. And, you know, I had an encounter a couple of weeks ago in worship. That's why I love Friday worship. It's just this, we've got plenty of time for him to reveal things. And I just so honor our worship team that they leave space for the Holy Spirit to speak. Hallelujah. And I so it's just an incredible blessing. When I travel, I can't wait to get home just to be in the worship. And it's not that we're better than anybody else, but just that opportunity as family to be able to seek the face of God. And so often he speaks to me in worship. And I remember, I think I was just personally worshiping at home, which I highly recommend. And I saw a vision of the eye of God, and he pulled me right up into his eye and right through it to the other side, and began to ask, would I like to begin to see out through his eye? And I thought about that as the Lord was speaking to me today, about the prophetic and the desire of God. I mean, you read elsewhere in Zechariah and Amos, when the Spirit of God's moving, who can but prophesy? But he's waiting for us to actually begin to use what he's given, waiting for us to begin to allow him to speak. And he wants to reveal it to us in such a way that, you know, the eye is the window of the soul. And God is not looking for us to just see with a cold, calculated view so that we can say, isn't that good? I saw something. But he's actually wanting us to give us his heart. He's wanting us to feel his heart, to know his heart, to understand the color of what he's doing. In that, the color is as in the emotion of God's heart about what he's saying. So that we won't prophesy just coldly or just information, but it will come with the love and the heart of God. You can prophesy all mysteries, but if you have not love, you've got nothing, the Bible says. And he's wanting to release to us a greater revelation of his heart so that we can see what we haven't seen before and deliver it in such a way that when people hear the word of God, it'll resonate in their hearts because they'll feel the love of God. Hallelujah. Our magnificent Jesus. There's so much more I would like to share with you, but I want to take some time tonight to pray for people. And we're going to have our team pray. But I want to, if I can, whet your appetite to begin to hunger and thirst for him. God is inviting us to begin to dream his dreams. He's inviting us into divine invitation like we've never experienced before. You know, I believe that God's wanting us to begin to recognize what he is dreaming about for our lives, what he's dreaming about for our city, what he's dreaming about for our nations, and wanting us to begin to rise up and begin to prophesy it, begin to declare it, begin to see it, begin to say it, begin to pray it. Hallelujah. A lot of people have the attitude, well, yeah, I could do that. Yeah, I could do that. And we know that. Yeah, I could do that. But really, if we get honest with ourselves, the statement should be, I could do that if I wanted to. In him, we can do all things. Hallelujah. But he doesn't violate our will. If you want to just sit in front of the TV and just let that fill up your screen, your chalkboard of your heart, you are free to do that. But if you actually want to come before the Lord, stand in the counsel of the Lord to seek him until you find him. Seek him and seek him with all of your heart. The invitation that God has for us is to be, if you want to ask him questions, if you ask the helper for help, the helper wants to help you more than you know that you need help. More than you want help, he wants to help you. He's so jealous to help you. But you know, I believe we're coming into a season where God is waiting for us to learn how to respond to what he's saying. And in this season of acceleration, in this season of increased glory and signs and wonders, where the detail, where the where the glory is being released in a far greater measure. We've only tasted a little drip. I tell you what's coming. I mean, Joel was prophesying about it tonight. This downpour, it's not a nice catchphrase. This is glory. Glory, where the priests couldn't stand to minister and beyond. That was then, this is now, and he goes from glory to glory. I mean, what's coming is awesome. But it's not something to be messed about with. We don't want to miss this season of invitation. We don't want to miss this season of visitation. We want to be aware of the times and seasons, and we want to position ourselves wisely, rightly, and say, I can see it coming. I can hear it coming. I can feel it. Lord, show me what you want me to do. Tell me to come to you on the water. If that's you, show me. He doesn't leave us as orphans. He doesn't expect you to go about blind, but he said, I will be the light to your path if you'll open up your eyes and let me show you. If you'll ask me for help, I will direct your paths. I want you to be real with Jesus. I want you to be real with the Holy Spirit. A lot of people, they hear the word Holy Ghost, Holy Spirit, and they think it's so ethereal that it's not tangible. Yet he is a person, and he's here right now. And if you'll ask him for help, he's the helper, and he's really, really wonderful and wants to give you more help than you've understood. So we're going to pray for some people right now. But before I do that, and I'm going to ask the teams to come, we're going to just prophesy and pray for the sick as the Holy Spirit leads. But before I do that, I want to ask you tonight. Now, this is not a season for messing about. There's some people that know about God or perhaps, you know, have believed that he exists. But God looks for more than our acknowledgement of his existence. He looks for our response to his mercy. And God, I believe, is wanting to just give you an opportunity tonight. If you're here and you say in your heart, I know I'm not right with God, but I want to respond to him. I want to come into relationship with him. I want to give him my heart. I want to ask him for mercy. I want to receive him as Lord and Savior. I don't want to mess about and play with him. I want to get my life right with God. I want to respond to his mercy tonight. I want to give you an opportunity just to do that. So if you're here and you know in your heart that you are away from God, that you're not walking in relationship with him, but you want to get that right, you want to walk in relationship with him tonight, you want to respond to his mercy, would you just wave your hand? I want to give you that opportunity. Is there anybody here tonight that says, yes, that's me? I want to just give you that opportunity to respond to the mercy of God tonight. Is there anybody here? Yes, God bless you. Is anybody else? Just wave your hand at me and I'll see it. Yes, God bless you. Anybody else? This is your, between you and God, this is your opportunity to say, yes, Lord, I want to respond to your mercy. Hallelujah. God bless you. Yes, God bless you. Is anybody else here tonight that says, yes, I want to get my life right with God. I don't want to be on the fringe. I want to come in and say, yes, Lord, here I am. I want to respond to your mercy and I want to stand with you. Yes, hallelujah. God bless you. Is anybody else here tonight? See, God sees that and his heart leaps with joy. Can we pray? Let's pray together. Just if you would pray this after me. Father God, thank you for sending your son Jesus. Have mercy on me. Forgive me for all of my sin. I receive your mercy. I believe that you died and rose again. Lord, I bring you my sin and I exchange it for your forgiveness. I bring you my life and I exchange it for your life. I exchange it for your mercy. I exchange it for your righteousness. Thank you for your love for me, Lord. Give me eyes to see. Open the eyes of my understanding by your Holy Spirit that I might know you in ever-increasing ways. Help me, Lord. I need your help. And I receive your grace. In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Father, we celebrate. We celebrate with you. Thank you, Jesus.
You know, and I just want to honor you as you've made that fresh commitment in your heart, or even if that's for the first time. You know, this isn't something that God takes lightly. He sees it and he says, yes, yes. So, Father, I just pray for each and every one here. Lord, that you would seal them with your blood, that you would help them. You've seen their willingness tonight to respond to you. And Lord, I ask that you would help them. Lord, that you would revive their hearts. Oh God, that you would reveal yourself to them, that you would make yourself known, God, as only you can, Lord. Supernaturally, make yourself known. Make yourself real to them. Let them know that you are with them as they lie down, as they get up. I thank you, Lord, that you deliver them from evil. Father, I thank you for your grace to keep them. Lord, we bless them. I thank you that you surround them with your favor as with a shield. And Lord, I ask for ever-increasing hunger, Lord, to go after you and to receive all that you have for them, that they might walk in the knowledge of the joy of your salvation. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Hallelujah. That's lovely. Yay, God. I'm just going to ask some of our team to come. If I could ask Pastor Chris and Nick and Gareth and Joel and Wayne and Sharon and Kim. I see you over there. Hallelujah. Is Andrew Chi here? Hallelujah. Shaka Mahreya Su Papa. Esther, you want to come? Thank you, Lord. You know who you are if you want to come. Hallelujah. Tom and Sam, do you want to come give me a hand if you want to? You want to stay there. That's okay. Hashabokurama sandeaba. Thank you for your grace, Daddy. Lord, you're so faithful. Lovely Jesus. Lord, we bless you. Father, I thank you for your anointing. I thank you for your grace. Hallelujah. I pray for the lady in the blue here, just with her eyes closed. Yeah, just here. Would I be able to pray for you? Come. Shokura masate abba. Hallelujah. Could I just get someone to come stand behind her? Thank you, Lord. Sheki esu papapa. Thank you, Lord, for your grace. Thank you, Daddy. I just see that there's been lots of adversity going on around you. There's been lots of, it's like strong winds trying to blow you off course, but you have, it's like stubbornly put your flag in and said, Lord, here I am, I'm standing. And when you've done all to stand, stand, says the Lord. But the Lord says that you're in a season of transition, and he says he's seen and watched your perseverance, and he says you've been chosen in the furnace of affliction. And the Lord says that there's been a process going on inside of you, that he's given you hinds feet for high places, and you are a dreamer. And he says, I want you to begin to dream afresh, dream bigger. For the Lord says, blessed are you who has believed, for there will be a fulfillment of these things promised to you. And the Lord says, you are not only going to come through, the Lord says that you're going to come through with many and with much. And the Lord says, Sheki Amapa, you're going to come with sheaves, with sheaves, with armfuls. And the Lord says that there's a grace upon you. The anointing and the testimony of Jesus on your life is going to cause many to begin to hunger, many to begin to come. And for the Lord says, he's called you as one that is salt and light, and that you are salt. And even the tears that you've cried, the Lord says that he's seen it and he values it. And he says it's not been sown in vain. For he says you will reap with joy. So, Father, I thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Tom, if we could get you to come. Hallelujah.
The word elbows, any elbow complications. There's also just joints. It's got a general sense of joints as well. Any stiffness, any pain and things like that in the joints, and particularly elbows as well. Just come forward. We'd love to pray for that and see that all gone.
Man with the was wearing the black t-shirt. Here he is. There you are. Hey, hey, hey. Tom. Tom, I'm seeing two obstacles, and God is about to move them. He's going to remove those obstacles, and he's going to move them out of the way. And he's going to, there's a door that is opening for you, and you're going to walk through that door. I'm not seeing whether it's a, what it is exactly, but God's saying you're going to go through this new door. I will move those obstacles.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Can I pray for you? Would that be all right? Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord, for your grace. Shukalabasa. Wow. God's seen your hunger and your desire. And the Lord says that you shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. And the Lord says that even as you have been one that has put your hand and said, Lord, here I am. It's like you are not content to just be put off by the bluff of the enemy. For the enemy's tried to bluff you with a closed door, with a brick wall. But you've said, Lord, I know you will make a way where there seems to be no way. And the Lord wants to honor your faith tonight. The Lord says that he is coming. He's the God of the breakthrough. And the Lord says that I will make a way where there seems to be no way. And he says, I've given you prophetic sight to see through that which the enemy would try to blind you with. And you've said, Lord, I know it doesn't look like it in the natural, but I know that you're going to make a way. And the Lord says, yes, son. He says, shakaramasa, watch and see. Stand still and see the salvation of God. See the breakthrough of God, for the hand of God is with you. Shekiasa. And the Lord says, Shek, he's putting words in your mouth, words of wisdom, words of grace. For the Lord says, Sheki, you've been tempered in the fire, but you've come through as gold. And it's beautiful. It's beautiful. You reflect him beautifully, says the Lord. Shapara. And the Lord says that he's been polishing you up to shine like a star in the universe as you hold out the word of life. And the Lord says that you do hold in your hand the word of life. And you are freely, you are one who shares freely. And the Lord delights to share his heart with you, even as you freely share with others. So, Father, bless him in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Yeah. Tash, can I pray for you? Hallelujah. Good to see you girls here. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. How you doing? Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord. I just see a lot of things is all around and just sort of swirling around. But I just see the Lord like turning a spotlight on you. And so it's like everything just becomes still and quiet. And the Lord, and it just becomes like you and the Lord. And I thank you, Lord. And it's almost like tractor beam at this light that, Lord, is it lifting you up. He's the glory and lifter of your head. And I see there's a whole new level awaiting you to walk in that God has for you. It's a level of spiritual promotion. And I just see that trusting and resting in him, just trusting and resting in him, just trusting and resting in him, and up into the next level and walking into the next level. And there's levels of spiritual power, and I just see people coming to you that need help, people coming to you that need healing of the soul, physical healing, emotional healing, torn backgrounds, people coming. And the Lord is going to give you such a level of the prophetic that you'll be able to speak in the word in season into their heart. And I just see the seeds of healing of the Lord going into their heart, just like the normal Christian life, when Nathaniel released the word, and in the word was deliverance, and the Lord is putting deliverance in your tongue, the Lord is putting deliverance in your mouth, so that you, when you release the word from heaven, that it will get the devil off their back and set them free. That's what God has got for you, and he's raising it up in you right now. I thank you, Lord, for a releasing of that prophetic gifting right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. More in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father.
Daddy. Robin, can I pray for you? Holy, holy, holy. We're going to have a new stage. We're going to move it around, and I'm going to have more room here. Hallelujah. It's going to be good. Thank you, Jesus. I'm just seeing it, saying it. Hallelujah. But when I saw like a trail of crumbs that you've been following. And it's like you've been, it's been like on a little hunt where it's like, God, I know that there's something, I know that there's some more. I know there's more. I know there's more. And you've been taking the little bits. But the Lord says, Shokura Masa, He is inviting you in to dine with Him. And the Lord says, Sheki, even as you have tasted, the Lord says that He's about to release to you an overwhelming revelation of His love for you, an overwhelming revelation of the Father's house. I hear the words, He brought me into His banqueting table and His banner over me was love. And the Lord says, I'm the glory and the lifter of your head. And He says, you're about to come into a season of intercession that's beyond what you've been in before, because you are no longer going to ask. It's like, oh, please, God, a little bit, a little bit, a little bit. The Lord says that you will lift up and you'll say, I know my Father hears me. Because you see the banner over Him, that's love. And the Lord says, you're about to step into a new place of authority, that you are one of the ones that's been chosen for promotion, where you're going to decree a thing and see it established. And you're going to begin to pray with such grace, such power, and such authority, because you are going to stand even as Jesus did before the throne of, before the grave of Lazarus. You stand before the throne of grace, and you're going to stand, be able to say, even as Jesus said, Lord, I know that you hear me. But the Lord says also He's going to use you as an example to many, where they're going to say, I want to be able to walk in that level of authority. And you're going to lead them. For the Lord says He's given you a heart of a mother. And there are many that are going to be encouraged by the fruit that they see that comes forth from your prayers. So Father, I say thank you. Amen.
Sam, would I be able to pray for you guys? Would you come up, both of you? Awesome. Thank you. Jesus, we just thank you for this beautiful couple. I just see such a greatness over you. I see there's like a big blanket of glory just sitting and resting on you, and it's like a blanket of love. And I feel like He's called you to love, and I feel like He's asking you to lay down your lives for love, and I feel like He's sending you back out into the mission field. Whoa. And I feel like the tools that you received while you were at YWAM are going to be, they're in your hands and they're ready to go. Wow. And I feel like I just see like a real grace to love the unlovely, even like the little ones, just the orphans who have all of these things that people don't love about them. I just feel like God's given you the ability to just love and just heal and raise them up into adoption. Yeah. So we just release that, Father. We thank you for the Father's heart in Jesus' name. And we thank you for the mother's heart. We just bless it in Jesus' name. Thank you, God, for double recompense in Jesus' name. Whoa, threefold in the name of Jesus. Everything that has been stolen in Jesus' name. Full restoration in the name of Jesus. And we just thank you for blessing in their finances to be able to go where the Father is sending them in Jesus' name. We thank you for fullness to overtake them, for provision to overtake them, and blessing to overtake them in Jesus' name. Thank you for that grace to be resting on them right now in Jesus' name. Thank you, God.
I'd like to pray for my brother. I spoke to you earlier in the blue shirt, the beard. Come on, come on. Lorande. You got him too, have you? All right, you can PS. God's picking on you. Thank you, Lord. What was your name again? Grant. Shokoromosu. Wow. The Lord says that He has made you to be like a sign. Your very life will be a sign, a big, big sign that is going to cause people to stop walking in the wrong direction and actually cause them to be arrested in their heart and their thinking and say, ah, I need God. That there's a grace on your life that He's going to make you like a sign and a wonder. For you've been one that's been polished to shine like a star in the universe. But the Lord says, as He's made you to be this sign, the Lord says that there's a grace on your life for increase. He says He's going to increase the signs and the wonders. He's going to increase I see the revelatory gifts are being opened up to you like never before. And it's going to be the secrets of men's hearts. People are going to say, how did you know that's what I was thinking? How did you know that's what I was planning to do? How did you know that this was happening? And you'll say, the Lord's shown me because He cares about you. And I see actually lives being saved. That there's people, even as we saw that video tonight, there's even going to be
God's going to show you insight into people that have been really struggling, and they'll say, how did you know? And you'll say, the Lord showed me. And people are going to be stopped from doing things that would have caused them harm. But he says there's also going to be a grace on your life that is going to cause such joy. That I see many Christians that have been discouraged or almost tired and weary. And the Lord, they're going to see the joy of the Lord. They're going to see the signs and the wonders. They're going to see it and they're going to say, I want what you've got. And the Lord's giving you grace to equip the saints for the work of the ministry. He's giving you grace to encourage them. And I see just the joyful gentleness of Jesus coming through. That people are going to feel so safe with you. That they're just going to... just like little children wanted to be close to Jesus, people are going to feel safe to come close, and they're going to experience Christ through you. For the Lord says you are a living epistle that'll be read by all men. So, Father, I thank you for that. I thank you, too, for the gift of sight. Yes, Lord, sight for vision for the future, too. I see that God's going to show you things to come. And he's even for your own life, the Lord wants to give you hope for the future. Hope for the future, that it's not going to just be the same old. God has actually chosen you for acceleration. So, Father, I just release an impartation tonight. Father, for the revelatory gifts, the anointings. Father, the seer anointing in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
And while you're laying down there, I just saw you say to yourself a few times, see, I'm bored. And the Lord says, promotion is on its way. Promotion is on its way. Thank you, Jesus. And just before I was waiting on the Lord, and I just, somebody here that you've been just diagnosed with a tumor, and God wants to heal you of that tumor. Who's that person? Just come straight out the front now. Thank you, Jesus. Tumor. Who's been diagnosed with a tumor? Don't hold back. Come on. Jesus wants to set you free. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Who's that one? Hey? Got a lump? A lump on your body? Who's that one that's got a lump on their body that wants free? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Well, was that you? Or are you just having a laugh? No? It is? Come on, love. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
About you. I see you just having this spring in your step, and everything is happy. Like you get up in the morning and it's all good. It's all good because God is good. And I just see the Lord is just, I see he's making his steps for you sure. He's put you in a firm place. He set you on the rock, and I see he has an incredible plan, an incredible destiny for your life, far above what you could even possibly imagine. So I just thank you, Father. I just release joy over you in the name of Jesus. I just see joy bubbling up inside. Thank you, Jesus. Let it come up. Let it come up. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You're going to be known as a woman of joy. People will get around you and they just can't help but be happy. Surely. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And just real quick, sorry, Tom, just as a PS as well, I just felt the Lord was saying that you have the heart of a father. And I see you just fathering people. And I see you've just gone really low. And he's bringing you up. I see he's bringing a promotion to you. And I feel like he's saying, wait and see for the glory that I'm going to pour out. Wait and see. I see this glory is so thick. It's so tangible. And and it's just going to radically change lives. So I just feel like he really wants to encourage you with that. So bless you.
Thank you, Father. Can I pray for Carmen? Yeah, come on up. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Lord, we just bless Carmen. Carmen, I just saw I saw a picture of you just entering through this door, and it was an interesting picture. It was like a revolving door, and I saw you going in one way and almost coming out what felt like the same way. And I don't know if there's been some things that have been going on with I believe there's been promises that God has put in, dreams that God has put upon your heart. And the interesting thing with this picture is it kind of felt like, oh, you know, I went through that door and I'm back to the place, the same place that I was. But I saw that there was another dimension to this image, and it was almost like as you were entering this door that you were actually taken up on another level. And it was unexpected that this was an elevator at the same time. And what I believe that God is going to begin to pour out great, great favor upon you. And I see you taking steps. And God says that you've been faithful with a little, and there's been dreams that have been upon your heart that he's going to begin to pull out, and it's going to begin to come faster and faster. And I see you even beginning to take these steps, and it's like one step, and then it's going to be like 2 feet, then it's going to be 4 feet, and there's exponential growth that you're going to begin to walk into. And I see that God is just beginning to expand your heart to love really, really well. I see these kids actually coming to you, and you're just loving on them so well. I hear this sound of their voices saying it again and again, like, nobody has loved me like I've seen love in Carmen. So, Lord, we thank you for that in Jesus' name. Lord God, that there's favor and blessing, abundance in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, right now. Urakasha.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Becky, just stand up. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Well, thank you, God. Well, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I just see there's been areas that have been really stretched and pulled tight, and even areas that are dry. But I just see the Lord has got a bucket, and there's a string that is ready to drop over you. And I just see every area being covered in the glory of the Lord. Every area being pressed out in the glory of the Lord. I just see like fine linen being ironed out in the glory and presence of the Lord Jesus Christ. And there's going to come like, it's like a dripping of the Lord's love and presence over you. It's going to come like this dripping. And I just see you ministering to young kids. Ministering to the young kids and youth, I see a mass amounts, more than you actually know, more than you actually realize, are going to come around, are going to look to you as mama, look to you and just see you as a presence of God, presence of love being felt. They don't know why at first, they don't know why they come, but they come because of the presence of the Lord. They don't realize it, but they're finding home, they're finding Papa God. They're saying, oh, this feels right, but it's Papa God. And God is going to start pouring more and more and more, and as you give out, the Lord is going to pour more of his love and more of his love and enlarge his heart for you. And he's already been doing it in the past 12 months. You've had bigger heart, but more is going to come, and bigger than you expect. So right, get ready right now. I release a deeper and bigger heart of the Lord, a dripping presence of the Lord God in every area in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Now I actually want to just open up an opportunity. You've got something, I can see. We'll do one more. And then I want to actually have a fire tunnel. And the reason I want to do this is whatever you are seeking from the Lord, I want you to take from God. I want you to receive. But I also feel like we've come into we're entering into a season now that is actually, you know, serious but glorious. And I've been feeling for a while, it's almost like the end of a movie. It's been the sense, you know, where subplots start to get resolved. If you're watching a movie, all the little subplots start to get resolved. And I've been feeling for a while like God was just
a lot of those little subplots that have been going on in your life are coming to resolution. But the Lord is saying that it's now, it's like the end of a season and something brand new. And this is a season where the windows of heaven are being opened. That is the eyes of God's heart, that capacity to feel what he's feeling, see what he's seeing, do what he's doing in an increasingly aware, awake state is being released. So when we have this fire tunnel tonight, I want to release an impartation to see like never before for the heart of God, for the eyes of God. Hallelujah. That we might, you know, the Bible says, talks about impartation through the laying on of hands, that spiritual gifts might be imparted. And I really feel to do that tonight. So we're going to have one more and then we're going to have a fire tunnel. Does that sound good? Hallelujah.
Could I have Lulu and her husband come out? I was just seeing you both sitting there, and you've got the glory of the Lord all over you. And I just feel your house is a house of love. It's a house of worship. And I believe the Lord is going to increase the hunger in your hearts. You're already hungry, but I believe that hunger is going to grow so much. And there's going to be an increase of numbers into your house. I don't know how this will come about, but increase. It's going to be a house of worship. It's going to be a place where people feel safe to come into the presence of God. And you guys, you've got so much love to give. And the Lord delights in that. He sees you and he delights in it. He's given you the desires of your heart and he's going to fulfill all that he's called you to do. Father God, we just call down an anointing, a fresh anointing, Father God, upon this couple. Father, Lord, that you would pour out your spirit afresh upon them, Father. Lord, I thank you that you've heard their cries in the quiet places, Father. I thank you, Lord, that you will answer their prayers. I thank you, Lord, for an outpouring, a fresh anointing in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord, for the glory of the kingdom is on you. Thank you, Father. He's so proud of you. He loves you so much.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Well, I'm going to just ask our pastors and leaders if you can come, and we're going to have a fire tunnel. So what we're going to do is, you could come through and just have hands laid on you and nothing happen. But if by faith you are going to receive an impartation that you pull on heaven to receive from God, I'd be pulling on heaven for a fresh revival and anointing to be able to hunger and thirst and to see like never before. I'm going to be praying for eye salve. Lord, give me eye salve. I want to see. I want to be fully aware, fully awake. I want to enter into this new season and I don't want to sit back and be a spectator. I don't want to be content with what I have done in the past. I want to actually align myself even more freshly with you in a deeper way, in a deeper capacity to recognize and to begin to enter into the all things are possible through him who loves me. And in Christ, we can do all things. So I want to release that impartation tonight. So if you want to get ready and come, can we have the leaders come? And we're just going to stand and we're going to have a fire tunnel tonight. Hallelujah. I encourage you, if you can come out on Sunday at 4:00, I'm going to be preaching. I'm excited about what God's got for Sunday. So come out and join us. It'll be wonderful. If you want to bring a plate of food to share afterwards, you're welcome. If not, that's fine too. You're welcome to stay and join us anyway. Lord bless you and keep you and make his face shine on you. The Lord be gracious to you and lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Thanks so much, Joel. If we can have some music, that'd be wonderful.
Hands. You were more than words could say. I follow. this world of faith. I'm pressing on till I see your face. I will live that your will be done. I won't stop till your kingdom come.
Oh, We speak your name, we lift our eyes to now hearts. flames in the horizon, but at my door.